Well, caught a cute little baby hognose snake. Make sure it's focusing good. Got his little head all flattened. What a cutie. Oh, he's so soft. Caught a really big one here earlier this year. So hopefully there's one. I hope there's more. Sweet. Caught a toad. Whoa, there he goes. Well, I caught a good sized hognose. My favorite snake. He's not playing dead yet. So cool. Beautiful snake. Well, you can hear the gray tree frogs in the background too. So cool. His head's not flattened anymore. Alright, I'm gonna let this beautiful hognose snake go where I found him. So beautiful. First gray tree frog of the day.
Gotta put my hat, my hunting hat back on.
I'm gonna video you. Trying to grab him.
Okay. Hope you, are you shooting?
Got him! Just found a big blue spotted salamander, of course. I'm going to put him back where I found him. Well, I just caught a little painted turtle who tried to bite me. Ouch. Yeah, I shouldn't be putting my finger in his mouth. Well, he looks pretty cool. It's a Midland painted turtle. I just caught a teeny tiny painted turtle. He is really small. Get that to focus. This was a nice unexpected find this evening. I heard a few chirping, but I thought they were way up high in the trees. Gray tree frog. Whoa. Heard a green frog over there. All right, so beautiful. I was wondering what was wrong, or what got this gray tree frog, and there's a water beetle on it. Dang. The giant water bug, the toe biter. Little bugger. There he goes. I'm gonna put this guy back where I found him. Caught a water snake here. And I'm gonna let him go before he takes a bite at me. Alright, I'm gonna let him go where I found him, which is right down here. Well, here is a helgramite. And I hate caterpillars, and this thing is really giving me the willies. Because they can pinch. Well, a couple helgramites. And I'm going to let them back in the pond. They turn into Dobson flies. Well, I caught a giant water bug. And there's a helgramite in there too, but I'm going to let them both go. Well, I got this toe biter here. Well, I'm let this toe biter back in the pond. Giant water bug. Really pretty green. Can't tell here in the bright sun. All right, here goes. I don't know what this thing is. It looks creepy. Whoa. He's ready to bite, I think. By my little frog pond. I believe this is an American oil beetle.
Hey, my friend David Lawson here found, what'd you find, Dave?
An American oil beetle.
An American oil beetle. Really a cool little animal, beetle anyway. It's really quite large for its size. And it has this awesome black oil looking back that has little tiny bumps that we'd have to get really, really close up to catch. I'm waiting for him to just see if he'll settle down a little bit so we can get some really tight shots here, but I don't know. He's in no mood right now to just be slowing down. I'm gonna try to zoom in a little bit. It's not too bad. You gotta be careful with this beetle. It is toxic. And Dave was telling me he did a Google search that if you squeeze it or it feels threatened in any particular kind of way, it can exude a toxic fluid that can cause blistering. And David doesn't want blistering on his hands, and I wouldn't want to see that on his hands either. So we're just being nice and gentle, letting the animal walk where it wants to walk. And that's probably about as tight as we're going to get close-up-wise. So, nice beetle. Hey, good catch. Good find, Dave.
All right. Got a golden garden spider here. Really pretty. Now, what'd you say, Bob, about her legs being brown instead of black?
Yeah, this particular species, and I haven't found enough research on it yet, most of these golden gardens, or Argiopes, will have black markings on the yellow. If you look close at that abdomen, it's brown, actually, as well as her legs. They're tan with brown rings or banding, which is unusual. I've only seen a few of these. I don't know exactly if it has a different name other than it's, well, it's Argiope, but there might be a different species of this with this coloration. The front legs on a normal, well, I shouldn't say normal, but on most Argiopes, black and yellow, will have pitch black legs from head all the way out to the point of the toes. And that's on the front two legs on either side of the head. The next legs will have, near the body, orange or reddish color near the femur, and then the rest of the legs are also black. So this is a very unusual coloration for this spider. And Dave's being nice here to allow her to enjoy the warmth of his hand.
Well, I caught a little baby water snake. I was looking at this little baby water snake, and this looks like a moth landed on my hand. I'm gonna let this little snake go. Kind of mucky down here. This guy is still on my hand. See the shadow of my camera though. Cool. pond is drying up some, actually quite a bit, but I've seen it where it was totally dried up, where you could walk right across the thing. Well, the first ribbon snake of the year. Besides, I did find one that didn't make it into hibernation from last fall. I found him a few weeks ago that was, he was a big ribbon snake and he was dead, and then something ate him later. But what a nice find. I'm out here just looking at frogs and stuff, wood frogs and spring peepers and chorus frogs. What a pretty snake. So cool. Well, I'm let this ribbon snake go where I found him. My first garter snake of the year. And I don't believe I've seen them by this little pond before. Just ribbon snakes and water snakes. And hognose snakes. So this is a cool find. Well, I came back to the pond and found two more mole crickets. These guys are amazing. Make sure you focus on them. Don't want to squish them. Here's the pond. All right, I'm gonna put this mole cricket down. Watch him dig. If he will dig. There he goes. Pretty cool. Well, I found a polyphemus moth, or polyphemus, the larva, and the moths are huge from what I Googled. Just a focus. Really big one. Well, got a six-spotted fishing spider here, and I'm gonna let it go back into the pot. A little ribbon snake hanging in this tree. I've seen him here once before. Well, I spotted a ribbon snake on the north side of town. Now I just spotted this one on the south side of town. But I caught a little water snake. I'm shaking a little bit because he tried biting me. Make sure it's getting in focus. Well, I'm gonna let this little water snake back where I found him. Look at that cool tail. Well, I'm out here in the rain, and there's this snapping turtle. I'm not going to try to pick up that guy. Might be a defensive move. Well, my camera is getting wet a little bit. I'll leave this guy alone. Alone, when you talk right. See you later, dude.
A wood frog. I'm pretty sure. It's pretty dark.
Oh. Cool. I'll let him go. Where I found him.
Well, I caught a good size water snake. That's why I got this glove on. Because these buggers will bite.
and we get a close-up. So I'm going to let him go over here.
And there he goes.
These two good-sized ribbon snakes are hunting frogs. I was hoping to see a snake. Pretty cool. Hunters. Nice. little spring peeper. Oh, there he goes. Well, first blue-spotted salamander this year. Pretty neat. And I'm going to put him back where I found him. This is a sad sight. The pond is dried up, except for this one little wet spot. I was here yesterday and there was a little bit of water. But all these tadpoles laying here just dying. I was just over there. And they were moving around. That's probably about a half hour ago. It has dried up that much since then. I think this turkey vulture has been eating those dead tadpoles.